shot my hand. Ombe say, ombe tell you to run.
Ombe, ombe.
Ombe say, ombe say, ombe. Well, pick me up with golden hand. Ombe say.
Scene 1, The Reader of Books. Starring Oliver, Mia, Harry, Abby, Lydia, and Jaden.
Every parent thinks that their child is perfect in every way, but in Matilda's case, no. They just think that she's an ignorant little brat.
All right, I'm going to work now. Behave, especially you, Matilda.
I will be, Daddy. Bye.
Bye, Matilda. I'm going to bingo.
I'm going to school with all the bag.
I would love to read a book, maybe I will go to the library.
So Matilda walked down the street to the library.
Hello, what book would you like? Wait a second, we need to be in the children's section. Follow me and we'll be there in a second. What book would you like? We have the Little Girl, The Three Little Pigs, and Goldilocks and the Three Bears. Have a nice time.
I've read all those books. Please, can I have harder books?
Okay, follow me to the adult section.
What book would you like now?
Please, can I have... Please.
What's your name again?
My name's Matilda. Why?
Because I've never seen you here before.
Please, can I have Moby Dick?
Yes, you may.
Thank you.
I'm home, Matilda. What is that? Is that a book? Go to your bedroom. You're grounded for a week.
Harry, I won, Harry, I won.
One more.
Bingo.
Oh, yeah. Show me the ruler.
So, Mrs. Wormwood won the 10K prize.
I'll show you the 10K prize, Harry.
Oh yeah, we should buy a computer with that.
So they went out and bought a computer with the money. And then came home.
Welcome home, son.
Where's Matilda?
In a bedroom.
Why?
She's grounded.
For what?
Reading a book instead of watching the TV.
So Matilda was grounded, yes, for 1 week. Yes, for reading a book.
Scene 2. In the garage. Ben, Lily and Harry.
Matilda,
hey,
are you in?
Yep.
What book are you in?
The Great Sales, and it's really good. They're all better than that.
Do you make money?
No.
Do you sell cars?
No.
Yeah, Matilda. Do you?
Sure.
I'm big, you're little. I'm smart, you're dumb. I'm right, you're wrong, and there's nothing you can do about it.
He's right about that. You're a crook. Can't you sell nice cars?
Young lady, I've ground you for a week or more.
You're so cruel.
You ignorant little twit!
How dare you! I'm gonna leave this family.
I wish you were true, to be honest.
Stop the car!
Scene 3, The Hat and the Super Glue. By AJ, Holly, Janine, Olivia and Millie.
Matilda was thinking about what happened a few nights ago as she came up with a plan to make her father embarrassed.
As her father was getting dressed, Matilda got hold of her father's hat with arcane unglued in the ring, smiling with glee, and gave it to her dad when he came down.
Here you go, Daddy.
Thank you.
hot day of selling cars, Mr. Wormwood came home with a hat glued to his head.
When he came home, he struggled to get it off.
Ow, ow, my hat is not coming off my head.
What do you mean? Come here, don't walk away. Come here, I'll take it off for you.
Stop, you're going to pull all the skin off my forehead.
What's wrong, Daddy? Has your head fallen or something?
Have you been using super glue? Because I think you have. Put some of the nasty stuff in your hat, then stuck it onto your head.
I've been in the garage all day. I've not been near that nasty stuff.
Maybe we can get it off tomorrow.
In the night, Mr. Wormwood could not sleep at all because of his hat.
Honey, is your hat still stuck to your head?
Yes.
I will cut it off your vision scissors.
It's better than nothing.
Daddy, your head looks like you've been dragged for a bush.
This is Scene 4, Throwing the Hammer, made by Emily, Ella, Sydney Lee and Eliza. Hope you enjoy.
Ha, your cousin is awesome.
Yeah.
Let's go play tag outside.
Yeah.
Matilda and Laughter meet her older student in year 6.
Hi, my name's Hortensia. Have you met Miss Trunchbull yet?
She's horrible, but she's the head teacher. I don't like the sound of her. She locks children in a dark room with bolts and broken glass.
Yes, I've been in there 2 times, once for putting honey on her chair. Here she is now. Good.
Fresh meat. Amanda Thripp.
Yes, Miss Trunchbull.
What are those things hanging down from your ears?
They're pigtails, Miss Trunchbull.
I am a pig, Amanda.
No, Miss Trunchbull. What's going to happen?
Oh no, what she's doing? Oh no.
Miss Trunchbull spins Amanda round and round until she lets go. Next minute, she's soaring through the air, just missing the fence in the garden area.
Scene 5, Bruce Bog Trotter. Doff Baff Dov Gee.
My father would not be happy if I tore down Miss Trunchbull and thrown me over the fence by my hair.
That is the secret of the headmistress's success. She does whatever she wants to us and gets away with it. Bruce Bog Trotter, come to the front of the auditorium.
Oh my god!
Eat it now!
Okay, thank you.
Eat it now! You look like you're enjoying that, Brucey. You must have some more.
No, thank you.
But you'll hurt Cook's feelings. If you don't
eat it, I'll lock you in the chokey.
The chokey. I'll see you at lunch.